Shohei Ohtani. I would be remiss if I did not give you the floor to try and place in perspective of what we are seeing from him this year, Keith Olbermann.
All right. Well, this is not a criticism of his work nor a diminishing of what he has done.
Okay.
It is almost unprecedented for the time that we're living in which the key is specialization. He is a generalist, and this is an extraordinary thing. I will point out there was a 19th century pitcher who one year led the league in earned run average and the next year was the batting champion. So these things have happened in history with two-way players before. I would say that I would like to see a little bit larger body of work, not that there's anything that suggests this isn't going to continue, but I'd like to make sure that it's more than just a couple of seasons before it's, you know, he's the greatest player of all time. Well, no, Babe Ruth is the greatest player of all time because he did this. He had a Hall of Fame pitching career and then a Hall of Fame record-setting hitting career. It's early, and my biggest problem with baseball right now, and it's true of all sports, is whatever just happened, if you phrase it correctly, it's a record. That's the most homers and wins by one guy on a Thursday in the middle of August. And people take this dead seriously, and people get credited for pointing these things out. And I just like to – the greatest baseball pitching season of all time was by Harry Krause of the 1909 Philadelphia A's. Mm-hmm. And nobody knows who the hell he is. His first 10 starts in 1909, he threw 8 shutouts, 10 complete games. We don't know how many earned runs he gave up, but it may have been as few as 2. And those were his first 10 starts. Then he hurt his arm, and the next year he's pitching for Portland to the Pacific Coast League. And I'm not saying that's going to happen to Shohei Ohtani. I'm just saying, please give me a little bit more context before I assess him amongst the panoply of all-time greats. Because I heard this all year, all spring, from friends of mine like Gary Cohen about how Jacob DeGrom was the greatest pitcher of all time. I was like, can we just get to the all-star break without his arm falling off? And so, nobody will do this now, no matter what the sport is. It's whenever I turn on coverage of the NBA or NFL, it's the same thing. It's like, he's the greatest player of all time. He came into the league 3 weeks ago, and I'm only being slightly hyperbolic about this. Let's just assess something at the end of the season. It's extraordinary. It's something out of, in terms of comps, you have to go to the 19th century to find anybody who was this good at both things, even for this period of time, because Ruth, of course, was a pitcher, small transition period of about a year and a half, then basically just a hitter. So it's remarkable, and it's Hall of Fame trajectory, but it's really early.
All right, so that's the long-term view. What about, let's just place it in 2021 box, is it most valuable? Is he the MVP of the AL?
By almost every definition of it, other than the fact that the Angels are once again not in a pennant race, and if they were, you know, maybe Trout would be injured for the playoffs, which would be poor Trout's luck.
Right.
Other than the contending quality that you like to see in an MVP, yeah, I mean, I think it should be unanimous at this point, for the simple reason that once again, when you say who's the greatest baseball player of all time, at least in American and National League context, we don't have a full picture for the players who did things similar to this in the Negro Leagues, but in the American League, National League context, what exactly, who do you compare to Babe Ruth? Who was, I mean, in his time, perhaps the best left-handed pitcher of the game, and then became a hitter, the equivalent of whom now would have to hit something like 150 homers in a season. So when there is a guy who could finish at 50 homers and double-digit wins as a pitcher, you know, just the 50 home runs might get him the award. But if you throw that added little, you know, frisson of excitement that is, oh, yeah, he pitches and wins. And I speak as somebody who was utterly skeptical of this when he came into the American League. Yes, I would say that if he were to sort of go home for the year or not play again or whatever for the season, I think still, yeah, this performance is most valuable player because it covers candidates and wipes out most of the other hitting candidates, and it holds its own against most of the other pitching candidates.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.